Welcome back to The Witcher 3. Alright, we've had enough fun fisting. Let's get back on the main quest and look for the thieves in the main square. Gotta follow them back and try to find information on the King of Beggars.
What's he doing here?
Why is your hair so grey, darling?
Quite smart. Like a raw wound.
The Persiflora's no begrudge most famous quartet.
But what is it, grey boy? Looking for adventure?
Hard times we live in.
There must be order.
Come on.
I see enemies on the map. It just disappeared. Now they're back. Are those bandits? Oh, let me help you, guards. Oh, they already got him. Well, I'll take the loot.
I'm watching you. Who do you think you are?
No! Don't.
Move on.
I accidentally started to loot that. I meant to loot the body. There we go. Grilled pork.
You look familiar.
Oh, I need to talk to them up above. How do I get there?
Eternal fire protects us. Gives monsters.
Can you grab that girl?
Hits.
No, too high. There we go.
The poor.
You lame?
No, Charles. Both legs in perfect order. And me arms, look, like a windmill's wings. There. See me waving them? Looky here. Just look. And my mind, thorough addled.
Been like this long? Addled?
Since me mother birthed me. Here's where it's addled. There. Showing you with me finger. See that? Me indicating.
Healthy as a horse, as far as I can tell.
Priests of luck, medics, herbalists. All claimed, I'm bewildered.
Well, they're wrong.
Matters little either way. Folk are generous to me. They enjoy watching me point. Like this. There. There.
Okay. I kind of like this dude.
You're happy. That's what counts.
I am. When folk ask me the way, I like that most, because I can point, like this, there, because I know my way around the city, oh do I ever.
So you gotta know where the Putrid Grove is, right?
Most certainly do, it's where I live, over the, there, that-a-way.
That-a-way, meaning where?
In Lace Halls, there's this alley, past a gate, not at all putrid and not a grove, fools call it that, but I know better.
And anyone can go there?
Of course, unless he forgets to say the old sow's farrowed piglets might not let you in then, but that's easy enough to say. Listen, the old sow's farrowed piglets. See?
Thanks for your help.
Well, that was easy. Didn't even have to follow a thief. I don't think it's worth getting on Roach. Can I really not give money to the beggars?
Help! Save me! I'm dying of poverty!
Look, this dude's...
Give us a crown!
This dude's dying of poverty and I can't give him money.
Give us a crown!
Here, do you want a Novigrad sword? You can sell that for 61 monies. There you go. Just, it's right there. Just gotta go forward, it's like 2 feet. Nah, he'll get it. Are those twins?
I can't see you, I sigh and soul.
They're exactly the same people. That's very strange. Let's just say they're twins. Identical twins. Sure.
Open up.
Who are you and what do you want?
Take a look. What do you see?
Yellow eyes, pair of swords, mutated killer methinks.
Heard this place was a meeting spot for oddities.
Heard right. Know the password, get him free. Don't know it. Gotta contribute to the Grove's upkeep.
Old sows farrowed piglets.
Ah. Welcome to the Grove, brother.
Yeah, really ain't much of a grove, is it?
What ails you?
Can't see out of one eye, my lord.
Hit him, Azrain.
Thank you, my lord. A right miracle you've worked. I'd like to repay you.
Convince those knaves on the city council that spells are not needed on a whim, but positively indispensable.
They won't listen, my lord. They're scared of Menga.
In that case, please convey that if any of them should fall ill, he can stick his head in the flames of the eternal fire. Now, permit me some rest.
That mage is awesome. Just healing people with magic.
Mom, you've got a man.
Texas.
He's lying in the street, so I took it.
You look me straight in the eyes and lie, just like your pa.
You're a good lad.
Now go play. Mummy's got to get some sleep before she goes to work.
You already take 80% of what we see.
It's me, she shares the nooks and crannies where you and yours cut the eyes.
So he saw comfort.
Is that? That's Triss! Triss!
About time we made something clear, sorceress.
Yes, high time.
Me and my men will manage just fine without the help of you or any other mages. But you, well, without our help, you're sitting ducks for the temple guard. Who do I spy?
Geralt?
Hey, Triss.
See you two know each other. See you two know each other well. I was curious whether you'd managed to find me, Witcher.
Your spies tell you I was looking for the Putrid Grove?
My skull would be a home for bottom-feeding river fish if I didn't keep an ear to the ground. And please, Putrid Grove? Ugly name for our cozy little hideout, wouldn't you say?
So what would you call this dive?
Dunno. The Garden of Liberty, maybe?
For a man who shakes down beggars and thieves for tribute, you're quite the romantic.
You say tribute, I say taxes. You say thieves, I say hard-working street clerks. See, Witcher, I've got plans, big plans, far-reaching plans to reshape this city head to toe.
Ever thought of seeking a seat on the city council?
City council is a puppet troop with a hierarchy of the Church of the Eternal Fire as its puppeteer. Until recently, that is, when Radovid and his witch hunters took the reins. The semblance of power don't interest me.
A man with a vision.
One day, the so-called free city of Novigrad will be truly free. But before that can happen, we got to rid it of superstition, farting around about the hallowed essence of the eternal fire. Nonsense for kiddies.
Apparently not. Cheering crowd at the execution. Mostly adults.
Any crowd or rabble will cheer to the stench of burning flesh. But one day, folk will understand the eternal fire's naught but a leash around their necks. They call this place the Putrid Grove. But it's the rest of Novigrad that's putrefied. This year's the last bastion of normality, sanity, reason. I'm actually glad someone like you's found his way to our city. Because it will be our city one day, Geralt. Mark my words.
Yours, plural?
Yeah. mine, and my friends. But that's a tale for another time. For now, I'll leave you two alone. Because I can see, well, you clearly need it.
Geralt, I have a lot of things to take care of in town.
I'll be glad to tag along. What's your arrangement? He using you?
Helping me to survive, actually.
6 months ago, if somebody said Triss Marigold would be working for a Novigrad criminal, I'd never have believed it.
6 months ago, Triss Marigold parted with someone very dear to her and had to start anew. Hasn't turned out like I imagined. Come on, let me give you a taste of my life.
Look at the way her dress ripples around and sweeps on the ground. It looks so cool.
Madam Sorceress, beautiful as ever. Damn shame to part.
Don't fret. Bound to be back soon.
Do sorceresses always have a massive amount of cleavage?
I take it you're a Novigrad on important business.
Important doesn't do it justice. I'm looking for someone.
More precisely?
Young woman who's like a daughter to me.
Her? Here? No, impossible.
She was here. There are witnesses, evidence. Was hoping you'd heard something. You've been here a while. I need you to help me find something, anything, a trace.
I'll do everything I can, of course. Who might know more?
Oh god, it pains me to think of how muddy her dress is getting, dragging in the mud. Oh, poor dress.
Another drifter in from Temeria.
Ah, whatever, she's a sorceress. She can probably clean it with magic.
Hello, Klug. Managed to get those magic incense ingredients?
Yes, somewhat with difficulties, you might say. I was walking along the canal with a sack full of goodies for you. Looked up and spied a trio of temple guards coming the other way.
Get to the point, Klug. No time today for one of your long stories.
Wait! A sack full of magicalities and they were coming straight towards me. I don't easily frighten, but I felt a cold sweat on my arse, I did. I'm afraid I had no choice. I dropped the sack in the water. I had to! When asked why, I claimed it contained a dead cat. You shan't believe this, but they believed me.
I need that package, Klug. I've got a contract.
It must be on the canal bed. Luckily, it was heavy enough to sink. I'm sure it'll turn up if you search.
You expect me to pay you, then die for my goods into that ice-cold filth?
I can basically tell her to do it, or do it myself. I'll get it.
I can do that. Where'd you toss the package?
Near the crane. Second bridge in from the harbor.
I didn't expect such devotion.
Wanted to freshen up anyway. Let's go.
Stop. Hear that? They've come for us.
The fool didn't break until I began to prick his heels. Every man's got his sensitive spots. Interrogated a mage once. Pain couldn't touch him. Tore off his fingernails, crushed his bollocks, nothing. Turned out, he was devilishly ticklish. I placed a beetle on his belly and set a mug atop it. Damn near went mad.
We were lucky this time, but you'd best leave via the sewers. The trapdoor's in the floor.
Take care of yourself, Klug.
I'm not sure if that story those guards just told is more funny or disturbing. It's really both. It's kind of funny, but it's also really fucked up. Let's go. You come in, Triss. Oh god. Hold on. Gotta lube up. There you are, necrophage oil. Oh, that critical hit damage! Sexy. Go to sleep.
There's a draft. Should be an exit here. Klug wouldn't have sent us here if there wasn't. Must be a lever on this wall that'll open the secret passage.
Free city of Novigrad. Name actually used to mean something.
The very reason so many mages came here after the massacre at Loch Mween. Thought they'd be safe from Rat of its Reapers. Instead, they jumped out of the frying pan into the fire. But Novigrad stands on top of a mountain of coin. And winning a war takes three things. Coin, coin, and even more coin. That's why they're exterminating mages, confiscating their property and possessions. And they'll go after non-humans next. The elves occupy slums, but the dwarves practically control financial life in the city.
Official word is that Novigrad will remain neutral. Somehow doubt anyone believes that anymore.
Judging by what Klug said, the parcel should be around here on the bottom. Unless the poor man was mistaken. He's been forgetful ever since Manga interrogated him. Seems to be suffering from a persecution complex, too.
Current must have carried the sack seaward. I'll swim towards the port. Coming with?
Maybe some other time.
Don't know what you're missing. Water's thick with pungent oils. Guessing it'll do wonders for my complexion.
That subtle Geralt sarcasm. Axeman's trousers. Superior elemental oil. Enhanced dragonite oil. Damn. Good stuff, but that's not what I came here for. Oh, there we go. Also, I'm about to run out of breath. I better do this fast. Hold on, let me see if I can craft those things. Nope. Let's see, what am I missing? I'm missing the enhanced elemental oil first. Dang it. What was the other one? Enhanced dragonid? I'm missing the dragonid oil in the first place.
Find the parcel? Or did you get wet for no reason?
Nothing like a refreshing swim in the filthy canal. Found a few fish, a rusty anchor, the carcass of a boat. Oh, and this.
Oh, my package. Hope the contents aren't soaked through. Oh, you're a doll.
Seem to be in your element.
Still remember my elements? How I use them?
Come on. 6 months isn't that long. It's not like I'm senile.
But you do have a history of amnesia.
I've recovered my memory completely.
Good. That should stop people from taking advantage of you.
Someone's been taking advantage of me.
I have, for one.
I've never even intimated.
We need to hurry.
Come on. A whole day wasted.
Same shit as always.
Oh no, it's the guy again doing the workout. That really does look painful. Well, keep at it, man. I'm sure you'll be big and strong soon enough.
Hey, hey.
You know, the sword's right there. Just gotta step forwards a couple feet.
Like yours.
Just how far south is this fabric?
The latest cuts and colors. This guy from
Greetings, sorceress.
Greetings, Brandon.
I didn't expect you to bring company.
Triss, you told this man you're a sorceress?
Of course. She was looking for work. That's her chief asset.
Are you, Triss?
I know it was reckless, but competition's stiff here. No one would hire me if I claimed to be a common rat catcher.
More importantly, no one would believe such a beauty could be an exterminator of rodents. But I'd prefer you not to tarry and begin.
Triss, you and Brandon here. You've agreed a price.
We settled on a full coin purse.
Brandon and Co. is a serious outfit. We've the largest granary in all Novigrad.
I can demand payment in advance. Should I really be demanding that, though? I don't even know what the job is. I mean, this is Triss's thing, not mine. I'm not gonna meddle.
All right, then. Let's get to work.
We need to place these crystals around the granary, near anything that looks rat-related.
Excuse me?
I'll cover half the space. You take the other half. Look for evidence of rat activity.
Thing is, I know what evidence of manticore activity looks like, but rodents?
Geralt, we'd both rather be somewhere else. I'd rather be sitting in a royal council meeting, but they killed my king. Look for crevices and droppings.
Once we place this incense, what then?
I'll cast a spell and the rats will leave.
Can't do that without sprinkling incense? Don't really feel up to looking for rat shit.
Stop whining.
My god, there's so many rats in here. This place is so overrun.
Looks like a good spot.
I don't like that guy.
Brandon? I don't either. He's much too fat.
Can't help but agree. But no. Notice how he didn't try to haggle.
Jesus, so really who cares if he's fat, assholes?
Triss, he's a merchant. He makes his living by haggling.
If I worried about that sort of thing, I'd starve to death in this city.
A master monster slayer in the world's largest city, looking for rat shit. Jeez. Think I plugged every hole in there.
All right. Get ready for some magic fireworks. Once I activate the incense, we'll have a moment to talk.
What's gonna happen to the rats? Are they gonna, like, all catch on fire? Or is she just lighting the incense?
Well.
What?
Now we wait for them to scurry away.
I think I missed it.
Interesting method. Never had much luck with rats. Once, I hit one with a fork in complete darkness, trying to show off my Witcher's senses. Masterful throw, really. Problem was, no one else saw it. How could they in the dark?
So, what do you think? Rat catcher? It's a long way to fall from being advisor to Temeria's king.
I'm just glad to see you safe and sound, and...
reconciled?
I was worried about seeing you again. Doubted it could be pleasant.
We said everything there was to say 6 months ago. I don't want to go back to that.
I'm not going back to it. It's just... it's one thing to say something, it's another to actually do it.
We promised to remain friends. I hope nothing will change that. So, tell me how Yen's doing?
How do you know I found her?
You didn't answer my question. How's Yen?
Yennefer? Wait, did I meet her? If I did, I totally blanked on it. I don't remember.
Don't know yet. Asking about anything specific?
Never mind. I got my answer.
Jesus, that's so many rats. Here's the question, though. They're all running out in a stampede. Where are they gonna go?
Well, well. Our lovebirds having themselves a little chat instead of working.
The job's done. Geralt, those are...
I know who they are, Triss.
My friends begged me to notify them if I encountered a mage, sorceress, what have you. Didn't have the heart to refuse.
It's a trap, Geralt.
This stank from the start.
Such a sharp sense of smell. You should have legged it while you had the chance.
I don't generally leg it. Here's what I think you should do. Pay up and march your boys out of here while there's still time.
Don't be ridiculous. I didn't hire a sorceress in order to pay her.
Take my advice, mutant. If it's not your business, stay out of it.
Do they really think they can take us?
Thanks for the advice, but I can't take it. All right, we've talked. Do what you gotta. Just remember, I can't help but get in your way.
Heard enough from this horse, son.
As have I. Neither is to leave here alive.
They really think they can take us. Come on.
You should have run.
How's my oil doing? Oh, right. I didn't put it on. Let's put the oil on. My enhanced hanged man's venom. What do we got? Let's get rid of the moon dust. Let's replace it with poison. Grape shot. First one, poison in the second. Jesus. Brutal. Look at this fool. Can't even move.
That bastard hired me on the assumption he wouldn't have to pay me, duped and trapped like a child. If not for you, we need to find Brandon.
If not for me? What do you mean? I mean, I certainly helped, but like... So, I mean, Triss is, like, way, way, way more than powerful enough to take on these dudes. Let's go find Brandon and have a chat. Hey! Surprise.
Don't kill me. Good sir, no. They forced me. Had I not told them, they'd have set fire to my home, my warehouse. The mage hunters know no mercy.
Bullshit.
Spare me, good man. Be not like those murderers.
Shut up. I should kill you. Thing is, you'd be no good to anyone but the gulls as a corpse. So you'll live and pay us double. Now.
Fine. Your coin.
Now, get.
Thanks, Geralt.
No need. Glad I could help.
You know, I've been thinking who might know something about Ciri. And I just got an idea. There's an Oniromancer in town, Kareen Tilly. Very capable, supposedly.
Never trusted in Dreamer's abilities myself.
Kareen's been very effective. You should at least try. She's taken a job close by. Follow the canal, away from the fish market. The house is near the first bridge. Its owner, Dejonkir, is a rich banker.
Not coming with me?
I've got some things to take care of.
Another rat-infested warehouse?
Not exactly. Nothing even remotely satisfying. Such are the times.
It was nice to see you again.
You too, Geralt. You should go now, before Corrine goes back into hiding somewhere.
What if I want to find you?
I live in the Bits, near the fish market. Stop by. It'd be nice.
All right. See you later.
Washed your hair lately.
Ooh. Level up. Level up, eh?
What was it happened to Faltest again?
You know, one thing I'm wondering about is if it's obviously dangerous to tell anybody that you're a sorcerer because they burn sorcerers, then why is Triss wearing that ridiculously extravagant costume? Well, I shouldn't say costume, hey, outfit.
Seen any prime fillies?
Oh my god, that dude's creepy. Look at his...
I've had enough of living.
Look at his face. Ooh. But yeah, why is she wearing that ridiculously extravagant outfit? Like, she's gonna stand out to everybody. You really would not want to wear that if you're not trying to stand out, if you're trying to blend in. I mean, jeez.
Just passing by, wanderer? Or do you seek something specific?
Who's asking?
Rudolf de Jonquier. Of those de Jonquiers, yes. My ancestors laid the foundations of this city. I now own its largest bank.
Didn't need a recommendation. Name would have been enough.
Father always said, all ought to know your merit, son. Don't hide them under a bushel.
I'm looking for Corrine Tilly.
Oh, you've come to the right place, then. Corrine is inside. Been there for a few days, dreaming the home's history.
Not interested in what's going on inside? Seeing it for yourself?
I'm a banker. Cursed homes scare me. Do you know how a haunting can affect property value? Point of fact, Corrine requested she not be disturbed.
Why do you need to know the house's history? You a historian or on a whim?
I bought this property a short while ago. Paid a pretty penny, I might add. Soon after, I witnessed disturbances. Led me to fear the home might be haunted.
What are the symptoms?
Oh, they vary. Giggling in the night, and furniture moving about in the attic, and last week... Well, you shan't believe it. I found human feces in the parlor.
I think I can deal with that.
I'd like to go inside, look around.
I don't usually let strangers rummage around my home. Twin swords, though. You're a witcher. You may enter, call that my whim. Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Bombs, economically.
Wow, this place could use a good dusting. Perhaps I can do that with art. Nope, all he did was wreck all the furniture and stuff. I just picked up bread. I cannot even imagine how old and nasty that bread must be. Oh god. Don't eat it. And I just got grapes. Grapes! Grapes don't stay fresh for very long, especially unrefrigerated.
Stop!
Hmm?
Go away! Don't do that! Leave it!
Hmm. Sounds like she's having a nightmare. I hear the giggling. Giggling children.
Put it down, please! That's blood! Don't spill it! Please!
Whoa.
Go away! Don't do that.
Hey, wait a minute.
Leave it!
That looks like a... Hold on. It's a relic. The, godling. Yeah, it looks like a godling.
Mm. Ah!
It's just a godling. Godlings are supposed to be good, right? Where'd it go?
Wake up. It's just a dream. Wake up.
What's happening with her necklace?
The attic.
What is happening with her necklace?
All right. Time to check the attic.
Put it down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it.
Look at the necklace. Also, oh my god, why does everybody have so much cleavage? Jesus Christ. Is that like a normal, like, nightgown? Is that a nightgown? Because it looks like lingerie.
Don't do that. Leave it.
You know, if she's almost naked, then I might as well take my clothes off, right? There.
Put it down, please. That's blood. Don't spill it. Please.
Silver pantaloons. What? Oh my god, I've got to try these.
Stop! Go away!
Silver, how stylish. Wait. Was that junk? Can they not be worn? Where's the pantaloons? Huh? Hmm? No, they're not wearable! Geralt, why?
Don't do that. Leave it!
Silver hair, silver pants, what could be more appropriate?
Wait till the next room's blocked.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's a godling, but, it was acting really suspicious. Almost like it was doing something to the dreamer. I just got raw meat. And it's not even rotting. I don't get it. How can this still be preserved? How? Drawing of a crib. There's the doll. Paper on which a crib has been hastily drawn by a child, it seems. Okay, so I need to find a crib and put the doll in it, I guess.
There was a cradle on the second floor. Wonder what'd happen if I laid a doll in it.
Okay, Geralt, thank you for telling me the solution to the puzzle. Was it?
Another masterpiece. An oven and a blackened grate. Oh joy. A riddle. Guess I should find an oven.
I don't remember seeing an oven anywhere. Guess it'd be downstairs, right? Oh yeah, I haven't gone into the basement either. Huh, maybe it's in the basement. Oh yeah.
Scared of wee little Sarah. Ain't that funny?
I wouldn't do that anymore if I were you, Sarah. You might scare someone so bad they'll hurt you.
Why would someone hurt me? Having a spot of fun's not allowed anymore.
What are you playing?
That lady fell asleep, and I've sent her some horrible dreams. I'll not her wake neither. I can do that, you know. Funny, isn't it?
Very funny. Thing is, I gotta talk to the dreamer, so I'd like you to let her wake up.
Little Sarah doesn't want her to wake. Little Sarah wants to play.
That's definitely a godling. But the thing is, godlings are supposed to be nice and helpful, and she seems... a little bit too mischievous. Keeping her asleep because she wants to play. I wonder if that's... I mean, they are also supposed to be very playful. I don't know if that's just a manifestation of them being playful. But it seems very not nice, which seems to go against, you know, one of the things about godlings, about them being nice. I wonder if maybe she's different. Maybe, I don't know, something's happened to her. Maybe she's a twisted godling or something.
You're lucky. I know you're a harmless godling, but others might not know, and then...
And how'd you know I'm a godling, eh? How's that, eh? Eh?
If it looks like one and acts like one, trust me, you're a godling. You give the dreamer nightmares and won't let her wake up. Why are you tormenting her?
I'm not tormenting anyone. Scary dreams are great. What I love is when this big end chases me. End's got these red...
Why do you live in a haunted house?
Tell you a secret. The house ain't haunted. Not one bit. I just pretend it is. Make everyone think that. It was sitting there all empty, so I moved in. Bigwig from the bank then came and bought it. I don't like bankers, especially not to live with, so I decided to give him a scare.
Gave the banker a really big scare. See, he paid a lot for this house and won't give it up easily, which is why you need to find another home.
I don't want to! I don't! I won't!
Trying to keep everyone away so she can keep living here.
Sarah, Novigrad's no place for a godling. But if you want to live here, that's your business. So let's make a deal.
A deal? What kind?
Leave the dreamer alone. In exchange, I'll tell the banker the house is haunted. For good, no way to lift the curse.
You tell him that? What if he doesn't believe you?
I'm a witcher. He'll believe me.
Yes? Yes! Yes! Do that, and I promise not to bother your friend, not even a little. You're awfully nice, you know.
I don't hear that often. Thanks.
Now go wake that sleepyhead. I won't stop her. She'll get up.
And now she's playing in the dirt with a stick. What a lovely home. God. How is she going to live here for years? I mean, how is she going to get food without being seen and stuff? And I don't know. I mean, if they saw her, given their response to non-humans or magicals or anything like that, if anybody spotted her, I mean, the witch hunters or the Church of the Eternal Fire or somebody would come by and just burn her on a... just burn her up like they did to the other people, probably.
Who are you?
Triss Marigold sent me to see you.
Gods. Horrible nightmares. I was supposed to dream the history of this house. Instead, I saw furniture. Hungry furniture that wished to devour me. I know it must sound foolish, but in the dream, well, it was all too real. And not at all amusing.
The work of a godling. She made people believe the house was haunted. Also injected your dreams with her little jokes.
And you managed to wake me. I feel fortunate.
We witchers have our ways.
I thank you very much. The dreams, they were awful. Any way I can pay you back?
There is, actually. I'm looking for a young woman who was seen in Novigrad.
I can certainly try to help. But I'll need to clear my head first. After those deranged dreams, I feel it's full of cobwebs. Find me at the Golden Sturgeon. I rent a room there.
All right. See you there.
All right. I'm gonna have to tell him that this place... the curse in this place can't be lifted, right? Let's hope he believes me.
Truth is, I saw Miss Corrine leave, but she refused to speak to me. Is the matter resolved? Or quite the opposite?
A bit of both. A demon had captured Corrine. I managed to free her, but the house is still haunted.
Did Corrine dream of the buildings past?
Yeah. Pretty horrid, apparently. Though she refused to talk about it. Nobody should inhabit the place.
So many crowns I paid! Oh, well. It shan't put me in the poorhouse.
Not surprisingly easy.
Truth is, we're already dependent on the Black Ones. Economic.
Alright. Well, I think that's a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far. And I'll be back soon.
Washed your hair lately?
Well, yes, actually. I just dove into the canal.